Before the famous Macaulay Minute,
yes,
it was Ram Mohan Roy. I don't know why they call him Raja. I guess he was a sellout to the British. So maybe the, but I think I consider him a villain in my eyes. Ram Mohan Roy writes to the British that he wants the benefit to them to bring British education to upgrade India. So this whole idea of bringing English and British style education and getting rid of our own system was something that he initiated, and then comes the Macaulay Minute.
And the British in Parliament, in fact, Edmund Burke, he said that we cannot take the oak from the banks of the Thames River and plant it along the Ganga.
Right.
So, you know, their institutions are serving their needs very well.
Right.
So let us revive those institutions.
Right.
So the very strong group in the British Parliament and among the British officials in India saying that we should restore their institutions.
And it's also very interesting, the conservatives were interested in leaving it alone.
Yes.
It's the liberals who wanted to mess with it.
Yes,
we think that the liberals are more easy to deal with and they are on our side and all that, but actually it's the liberals who had this huge idea of human rights. John Stuart Mill, being the leader of the pack, considered the head of liberalism movement, he and others, they were the ones who wanted to tamper with Indian society more.
Actually, the evangelicals, that is the people who wanted to Christianize India, and the utilitarians, which means John Mill and John Stuart Mill, they allied together.
So the alliance of Christian missionaries,
evangelicals,
and the what we would today call the liberal left, that alliance has been there since mid-1800s.
Yes.
So the alliance today also of those people is not a coincidence. Isn't that interesting?
Yes, interesting.
And in fact, the conservatives who just wanted to make money, they were just basically capitalists wanting to make money. They were not interested in all this stuff.
No.
That's very interesting.
And appreciative of India.
Yeah, we're appreciative of India. We have a wrong impression that that the East India Company was all evangelism. That's because our people are not well read.
Yeah.
And you know, you make a fool of yourself if you make a statement like that.
In fact, H.H. Wilson, when he went back as the first Bowdoin professor at Oxford, he used to keep in touch with Sen. I forget his first name. He was Keshav Sen's great grandfather. Mm. And he said that, you know, continue the demand for Sanskrit. Because your nationality, your identity is linked with Sanskrit, and you do everything that you can to frustrate this movement for English education.
So, you know, we have to understand, a lot of things we blame on the left, it is our own stupid people who demand it and bring it in. Because so this post-colonial also, because a bunch of idiots thought that they'll become important and become Gora Sahabs, and the next best thing to being a white man is to think like a white man. So it is our people who bring them in often.
But the encouraging sign is that we are now getting the capacity, the confidence and the determination to set at least part of our historical